Here we are. It's August 28th, 2021. I am 4 days away from hitting the road, moving out of this place into my truck. And I'm feeling very excited, pretty sad at the same time. It's a bittersweet thing, shifting lifestyles. It's a big change, and I've had a lot of time to think about it. I haven't worked in about 4 weeks, been prepping for the trip. It does feel like life is a big vacation right now, and I haven't even left yet. And the fact that I feel that, I'm so grateful, because I feel like your life should feel like a vacation, because we're here to live, and we're here to live our best lives. And I feel like I'm doing that right now. I feel like doing this trip is, it's me finally being honest with my authentic self and doing what I want to do in my heart. And the fact that it's happening, and that I'm so fortunate to have the circumstances in my life to make it happen, I'm stoked. I'm so stoked.
Look up, child. World is born. Shoes untied, and your soul's warm. Windows are rolled down.
Goodbye, little home. Sunny, I'll miss you. It is 4 p.m. Just got some groceries, got myself a sandwich for the road, and I'm feeling like this isn't really happening right now. This is it. I'm going. I'm just going to the woods right now. I'm heading to the Mogollon Rim. I've lived in Arizona for like 8 years. I should know how to say the Mogollon Rim. Anyway, that's where I'm going. Hopefully get a nice camp spot with a nice view. It's a Wednesday, so I hope it's not too crowded up there. And yeah, here we go.
To get through this rain, windows are rolled down. Moon is hanging low.
So I made it to my first campsite here a little later than I thought. But it's beautiful. The camera's not gonna do it justice, but the sky right now, it's something else, man. This is exactly why I came out here. First morning out here, and not quite what I expected with the rain, or the cloud cover. It's very foggy out, but I think the sun's coming up and starting to burn some of it off. I can see a little bit of blue sky. Probably gonna get up and make some coffee first and take it hour by hour, really. So yeah.
Okay, it is 7 in the morning. Just woke up at my first stop, and the clouds are clearing. There's this big clearing, and I'm wondering, I parked over there, and I'm wondering if I could drive the truck down this way to get an even crazier view. It's gorgeous right now. Can't believe I'm doing this. It's already so beautiful. Damn. Okay, I'm gonna turn the camera around in a second here to show you what I'm seeing, because I'm getting close to the edge.
Look at that, man. Can't get over how beautiful it is out here this morning. There's a fire ring right there, and I think I can drive the truck out here, so I might try that, because this would be a dope spot. Thank you.
out here at the Mogollon Rim in Arizona. I can't believe I'm doing this. There are flowers all around me here in this field. I'm in this big clearing where I moved the truck to, actually. I slept more in the woods last night, but moved out to this clearing to spend, probably to spend tonight. Anyway, I'm having my first cup of coffee out here. It's a pretty epic one. And spirits are high right now. I feel so lucky. I feel so lucky to be experiencing this, to have the resources to do this, to have the vehicle to do this. I freaking love that truck. Anybody who knows me, I freaking love that truck, man. And yeah, feeling good, man. This is just the start.
Oh, I'm headed to the mountains. I'll be back in a week or two. Don't you try to reach me, 'cause I won't pick up for you. I've got some things I need to do.
Watching the sun go down. We had some rain today. It's my first full day out here, and as things go up here on the rim, some storms blew in. It wasn't too bad, and now it's passed, and here we are. There's a beautiful clearing now in the clouds, and the sun's poking through. One thing I'm already realizing is there's a lot of stuff that you have to do every day when you're living this lifestyle. There's just like chores that you have to do. And maybe I don't want to call them chores, but they're just like the everyday essentials.
I'm trying to let go. I think it could help being alone. And I'm trying not to let you make me cry. I've spilled too many tears, and I think I deserve being alone. And don't you try to reach me while I pick myself up and go. I've got to do this on my own. I need
All right.
to build myself up.
You're about to witness my first attempt at a shower. Well, ran out of water, but still a success, I would say. That wasn't too bad. Okay, quickly checking in. It's getting closer to the end of day three here. Haven't moved. Got Race, Will, and Josh on their way up now to meet me here and spend two nights, so gonna be here two more nights, which I guess will make it Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, like almost 5 days in this first spot. But it feels good to be just taking it slow. Anyway, yeah, feeling good, feeling excited to have some company here with me for a little while. There is another group over there, as you can probably hear. They've been a little bit boisterous, but it's all right. Still beautiful as anything out here. I had a moment when I was just sipping my coffee and reflecting on how good life has been to me in the month leading up to this trip, and there's just been a lot of good things that have come my way, and I kind of got emotional realizing that this is quite possibly some of the best times of my life, and I'm really glad that I'm just soaking it in right now because it feels so good to just be here. And I'm just going to end it on that for day three.
Thank you, trees.
Well, cooking up the bacon.
I'm lonesome but happy. Rich but I'm broke.
Oh, we got it. Got it.
I'm just Cowpoke from Cheyenne to Douglas.
What's your take on this spot, this location, Josh?
This spot, it's got a clearing for days. It's beautiful. You get the grass out there growing, trees. Got Race, Blake, and William. It's living life.
Tell me about your go-to footwear in the wilderness.
My go-to footwear, usually you got some nice boots, but when you're doing with cowboys, you gotta rock the cowboy Crocs.
Cowboy Crocs?
Cowboy Crocs.
Can you show them to me?
They're American, made in China. Buy them at Walmart.
I'll pick up 10 spot.
You found out this mushroom.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Peach colored fly agaric. Manita mushrooms.
Cool down.
It's a highly toxic mushroom.
This one is?
Yes.
Oof.
Most common symptoms is including touching as poisoning, excluding excessive salivation, urination, defecation, gastrointestinal problems, decreased blood pressure, and profuse sweating. Death can occur due to respiratory system failure. Let's take path.
So it's day five now on the road, and I haven't moved. I've been in the same spot up on the rim, and it's now time for me to leave. And I'm feeling a little bit tired, a little bit run down, a little bit down overall. Spent the last 2 days with my friends Race, Josh, and Will, and it was really nice. They came and joined me at this awesome spot. Now it's time for me to get out of here. I'm gonna head up to Sholo. My friend Race, his family has a cabin over there, and I'm gonna do some dishes, do some laundry, take a shower, fill up my water tank. And then I'm not sure where I'm staying tonight. I should probably start moving towards Colorado because in 3 days, on September 8th, I'm going to an event called Gutted at the Great Sand Dunes National Park, and that's from here, probably about a 6.5, maybe 7 hour drive. Anyway, first spot, beautiful, good time. Now it's time to go.